You know, there's no like down.
It was just, it was just dimmer before. I should have sworn that right before.
This, we need to redesign this like interface for these lights.
Yeah, this goes like you.
I'm hitting the down button, nothing's happening.
Oh, there's work.
Oh, look at that.
We got a dimmer.
Wow.
Nice.
Set in the mood.
Okay, Logan.
Just saying.
I know. All right, so I would like to take this opportunity to welcome a guest, Norman Willis, who is a student entrepreneur here on campus. So I'll let him do most of the talking about his process and his projects, but I just want to give you some context also for Norman. So you guys have been, for the last couple weeks, been learning how to create some sort of problem statement based off your experiences and student experiences here on campus, and then taking the those questions that you have and that problem statement to guide some research. So we're really interested in human-centered design, right? That's what this class is all about, is creativity and figuring out how to design from the perspective of others and empathizing. So you guys have been going out, hopefully, and you've been interviewing students and creating surveys and reflecting on those experiences to then come back and design or draft an app that you could potentially make, or just to get the idea out in some sort of tangible form that's presentable. So I've brought Norman here today to show you, one, that it's possible to be a student and to have amazing ideas and then to go through with actually building something from those ideas, and to hear about his process, okay? So without further ado, Norman, take it.
Awesome.
And I'm going to take my lame Trello chart off here and give you a nice backdrop. There we go.
Awesome.
All right.
So hey, everyone. I'm Norman Willis. I'm a transfer student here from Bowling Green State University. And over the last 7 months, I made 6 apps, and I sold one before I came here. The app that I want to talk to you all about today is called Same Path. I created it at Bowling Green, and we discussed a lot about it just to make it better. I'll tell you all about it. Maybe you all can provide me with some feedback. But Same Path is just something I created just for people on the same path. I noticed, like, we have a million Facebook friends, but we only talk to like 2 or 3 of them. But we don't really talk to people with the same major. We don't talk to people who want the same things out of life. So I decided to create it. I was a transfer student at Bowling Green. I started off at Tri-C. I had like a 3.7 GPA when I got there, but I couldn't get in any honors classes. I was used to being in honors classes, and I wanted to be around honors students. I wasn't able to because I had too many credits, and they told me that I would just have to take whatever classes that they gave me. So I was like, I'm not going to let that stop me. So I created the Same Path for other honor students. All you do is type in what you want, the type of people that you want to be around, and it'll pop up, like their numbers, things like that. Right now, I'm in a process of writing out a private policy because people want to know what I'm doing with their information and all those things like that. So I can help out with all the ins and outs with your app and things like that. So basically how Same Path works, I can show you. That's another app. I'm going to talk about that. Same Path basically works where I have it on my tablet and on my phone. So basically, let's say, does anyone play a sport here? What do you do?
Volleyball.
Let's say you're new. You're a freshman here. But you really, before you even start practice, you want to meet your teammates. All you would do is just type in volleyball players at NDC or create a channel for that. And all those students that do that would just be on that same channel. Anyone interested in gaming or design or anything like that, you will create your own channel just for the same people, basically. And that's the reason I created it, because there's nothing worse than being in a room and feeling like you're by yourself or you're like the only person that does something. Like me and Kiva, we're basically working on the same project and we didn't even know it. So imagine if we basically just came up with a solution, which I feel like this is, where we can just have the same people to do the same thing. And I'll show you like how it works and all those things. This is a free app. It contains ads, and I just made it because I saw a need. There's also something else I'm working on. It's called Grandmother's envelope. When I was younger, I got paid for each A on my report card. So I said, why not bring that back to school? You know, we compete with everything else. Why not compete with our grades? So each semester, each student puts in $5, and the student with the highest GPA, or we discussed better ways of doing it, they receive that money towards their college education. So each semester, someone will be receiving something for doing good in school. Also, the person with the highest grade is an alternative. They can pick out like field trips to go on or just things like that. But basically, I just wanted people to understand that to get good grades, you know, or to actually put in the work, there's something that, you know, that can actually help out. Because a lot of times, parents or people just say, get good grades, and they're like, students are like, why? You know, what's the point? I want to basically reward people each semester. So what happens is people reach out to me through my email. I go to the school. I show them how the whole process works. When the next semester starts, they start it up. And in college, if this college wants to use it or any college around, the student with the highest GPA or the students that do the best, that money can go towards food, clothing, anything that college students really need. You know, maybe could pay for a car or something like that, depending on how many students are actually in the classroom. So that's another app I made. It's called Grandmother's Envelope. Also, I wanted to help you all with other alternatives to making your apps. There's an Android Studio. If you all know how to code, all you have to do is just download this. It's free. You can code. All it costs to put something on Google Play is $25. For Apple, it costs $99. So I do all my stuff through Google Play. But if you want to, a lot of more people have iPhones. So if you want to put it on an iPhone market, costs $99. Also, that's the same thing. And also MIT, they have an open, free app inventor. Basically, it'll show you everything that you're doing right there. And it's a great way to just make any type of app that you want. What else? Appy Pie. We discussed this as well. You can really create any type of app, and it'll show you what it looks like. If you're working with someone in this class, it'll be cool because you can actually get feedback right there. What else? And these are the other apps that I made. Back My Brain was actually the first app that I made. It's a converter. It basically converts any type of measurement or anything into what you want in like another language or I can show you.
Yeah, that was the first one, and I was just like, all right, I want to be rich now, so I decided to make that $1.
And what do you use to create that app?
There was some coding involved, but I used a website for my first app. What the app looks like. So for currency, let's say if you go to another country, it'll show you how much money it is in that country. So basically converts everything. And I decided to make it $1.99 because I just really wanted to try something different. Norman's Push, that's just like a daily motivation tool. I wrote my first book at 19, and I love self-help. I love helping people. So I created that with AppGeyser. I can show them that too. That's free. It's great. Norman's Vision, that's an app where if you see someone, I believe that nice people should finish first. And when I was at Bowling Green, I saw a lot of people, they would do nice things, but then they would feel like it wasn't appreciated. So I just started like sending like anonymous envelopes to people that I saw doing really cool stuff. So I decided to make an app for it. So if you want to participate in that, just look up Norman's Vision. If you see someone doing something nice, write them a letter. Just give it to them. Title to Tuition. Like I said, I wrote my first book at 19. It's just an app where I give daily advice on people to people on how to write your book, how to get copyrights, all those things. And of envelope. Now appetizer. This is really like the coolest one out here. So let's say if you have a website, let me say this, all you have to do is just copy and paste the URL, click go, click the preview. Now you have your own website app, and it's really that fast. And if you already have like an Android account, your app will be up in like a day. So it really doesn't take that long to make these apps with that website. And that's what I used to make my first app. But are there any questions? Because I know I'm kind of going pretty fast. Like, anybody want to know anything about what I do, how I do it?
What was your most successful app?
The one I sold, I guess I could say that was the one that was like the most successful. Same path, I believe that one's probably going to be like the most successful, or grandmother's envelope, because I think a lot of students will like that, just getting a lot of money each semester and just basically motivating them to get more better grades. But the one I sold, that one was the best. Any other questions?
Have you made any, how many apps have you made using just one service?
Which one did I like
most
of? I would have to use, say, the app Geyser one. This one I've probably made the most apps using that because I just show, it's really fast. So I've used that one. And also, this one probably would be the best if you want like all your intellectual property. This one's probably the best. Any others?
For a grandmother's envelope.
You go.
A grandmother's envelope. What if so? There's only like, does it work like by school? I'm assuming, or only the people who buy into it.
They can actually any school that wants to be a part of it. Mm-hmm. They're more than welcome to just be a part of it. They can just reach out to me, or I can come to them. You know, that's pretty much how it works. That's why I say even Notre Dame or any school. I first made it at Bowling Green, and they wanted to use it, but I transferred here, so, yeah.
Because then what if, like, you have two people with the same GPA, and, like, they tie?
Yeah, and that's what we were talking about. We were saying, like, two people can get A's, but we were talking, like, let's say you get a 99 on one test, and they get a 98, we'll probably just go by that or something like that, yeah. But, yes?
Is there any type of survey you do to ask other people what types of apps they should?
Yeah, we were just talking about that. yeah, I made Same Path because I felt the need. And I was saying how smart it is to actually talk to people because I'm just out trying to solve my problems in the world when really it's important to see what's wrong, what's going on in everyone else's world. You know, I created that because I wanted to be in the honors class. But if you actually go around and talk to people, I think that would be more effective.
I had a question for you, Norman.
Yes.
So if you were to categorize like your time spent on things, how much time do you spend talking with people and the idea process, prototyping something, and then like production?
It really varies. When I first started, I was just like, all right, I thought about it today. Let me make it tomorrow. Because I saw it was like, you ever just thought about something and then the next day you see someone else made it and you're like, hey, that could have been my $1 million idea. So I was just so in a rush to just hit it big that I was just making stuff so fast. Now I kind of just take my time and figure out what is it that people want. Before, the first app took like 3 months because I was just I was overthinking it and I just kind of needed to leave Cleveland to kind of get my head together. But the next apps that I made, it was a shorter amount of time. It's really time consuming because you have to know like graphic design, you have to make your logo and make sure no one else has it. So it's a great amount of time spent. I just think that if you have a partner or someone that can give feedback, like her, she really helped me out a lot. It can go so much more faster. Yeah. Is there like anyone that kind of like needs help with this app making process, or they got it all down?
I have a great idea for an app.
You do?
I don't think anyone else has done. But I think it would be kind of hard. Like, I couldn't make it by myself, I don't think. So, like, how could I get the idea out there, like, to someone?
See, at first, before I met her and everything, I looked at freelancer.com. I looked at all these places because I didn't know anything about coding. I didn't know anything about these websites. So I had to do a great deal of research and just figure out who was actually true with like what they were doing and who wasn't. There were so many people, and then I met people like on campus, not here. You'll always meet people that are like, yeah, I want to help you out. And then in the next week, they just kind of fade off. You have to just be like a really great judge of character, because anytime I stop in her classroom, she's like, all right, let's sit down and talk about it. You need to find people like that can really help you. And if you go on Freelancer, kind of look at their previous work, try to see like how many stars they get and things like that. Or just reach out to someone like me. I'm always willing to help, because there was someone who helped me like with my first book. I didn't know anything about writing books and stuff like that. I didn't know anything about this. So I just kind of, I'm always there. So I can give you my email address or anything if you just need that.
All right, I got another big question for you.
Yeah.
So do you see with every app that you build a certain sort of maturing of the way that you go about the process, or just the effectiveness of the app, or certain design decisions you make different?
I've learned just to trust my gut. Like with the first one, I doubted myself so much. I would wait until someone else said, that's a good idea, before I believed it was a good idea. After a while, I said, screw it. It's a great idea. I thought of it. You know, stop doubting yourself. And that's kind of what made me more efficient, pretty much. You know, because in the beginning, especially when you jump into something you don't really know that much about, you're always second-guessing yourself. It's not bad when you're actually looking for advice, but if it's just you, like in a room, you'll never get anywhere. So that's really how I've matured. I just believed in myself, pretty much.
That's awesome.
Thank you. And, I have the app on the tablet if you want to check it out, or anything else. Yeah.
Any other questions from Norman, guys?
Also, does anyone know of any like good tech companies? What I like to do, I like to build a great product, and I really just like to sell it, because I'm more of like a serial thinker in a way. Like I'll do something, and the next week I'm off to something else. So I really like producing something, letting someone else.
You got to talk to Ray Marr.
Right.
That's your guy. You got to talk to.
Yeah.
He's in connection with amazing tech companies and startups in Cleveland.
Is he around now?
Yeah. He co-teaches the 410 class in business.
Okay.
And they bring in startup individuals all the time to talk and do lectures. So.
Yeah, I would love to meet.
I don't think it's called Flash Start anymore, but there's an incubator downtown. The CEO of the incubator is named Chris Stack.
Okay.
And I can't for the life of me think of the name of it, but it used to be Flash Starts. And they do, they support startups and I can email you.
Cool. And also, like, I don't know if anyone has ever been here, like, really late. If you ever want to just check out, like, my project, I'm always here, like, at the computer lab. So I'm probably right here just working on something. So if you ever want to stop in and see what I'm up to, just come by. That's it.
Well, if I ask you one last question, it's no worries. at least one last hard question.
Okay.
How important, and you kind of touched on this earlier, but how important do you think it is to find the right group of individuals to motivate you?
It's as important as the idea, because if you're around the wrong people, it's never going to get done. And that's kind of what halted me for the longest time. You were like one of my biggest motivators, because everyone, like I said before, everyone that I talked to, they were like, yeah, that's a great idea, and then just never hear from them again, or they'll want to know what you're doing and try to create something close to it. And I really don't need that. I just need people who are on the
apps is, and just we just want to be great at a young age. Like, I don't want to, you know, do the same thing over and over and over again. I want to just create something great and, you know, live an excellent life from that, you know. And I just want to be around other people who are like that too. So finding those people is important, but you have to be a great judge of character, because anyone can fake it, you know. Mm-hmm.
I didn't have to be the last one.
Oh. Are you working on anything else after same path? Are you working on anything right now?
I created something called VoiceCab. And I know it sounds weird. The name will probably change. But all my apps kind of deal with something I've been through in my life. And I was in like a lot of spelling bees. And I got all the way to the second round of every spelling bee. So I created an app that's kind of like a spelling bee. So all you do really is just, you say a word, and the person's job on the other end is just to spell it. So if you say a really long word, it's just up for them to spell it, and you get points from it. That's it.
Awesome.
It's kind of like Words of Friends, but
yeah.
And another one called Lou. I like to know someone's past when I'm like dating them. So, you know, like I've never been on Tinder or any of those things, but people have told me about them. And it's based off like your face and things like that. So I made something that's like a resume. You know, I want to know how many relationships have you been in? Like, why did you break up? Why are you single? Things like that. And people may not tell the truth. I'm aware of that. But I just want to go deeper than just you look nice. I want to know, you know, why are you single? You know, what happened? What did you learn from your last relationship? And that's pretty much it.
I have another question now. Now that you're talking about all of these ideas that you cycle through, it's like you do actual like sketches for you. It seems like it's just like every day it's like a new idea.
Yeah.
Can you talk a little bit about like where your ideas come from? And I know that's a very bizarre question, but it's a crucial one, and to identify where and how do you go through ideas?
It's kind of like my songwriting process. Like he has said in one of the sessions, like, we just sit and write songs all day. And it always comes from like my life experiences. So if I'm going through like a really bad breakup, all my songs are about love. Or if I'm going through just a time where I'm just frustrated, everything is about that. And they just more animosity in what I'm doing. So same path came from not being around like-minded people. Luke came from me dating someone who seemed cool until I found out her past. And I was just like, whoa, if I knew about this in the beginning, maybe I would have never went down this road. And I wanted to know more about this person. That's my phone. I'm sorry. VoiceCab came from the spelling bees. And it's just like, I get these ideas usually really, really like at like 7 o'clock in the morning. It just comes to me. And I'm just like, I have to make this happen like today. And I just do it. It's just like with songwriting. If this guy named Greg, he plays a guitar. If he plays something that's really nice, I just have to write to it, and whatever comes up just has to come out. It's kind of like fluid. It just has to come out. I don't really stop anything. I just brainstorm like crazy and just let everything come out. Yeah.
Do you write down all of your ideas, or do you just like when you get them, you act on them, and that becomes your focus?
I have to sometimes. Like, sometimes I'll be writing with my left hand and scrolling on the computer, like, making an app. Like, I have to do both, because sometimes it's just, like, so much going on, and I just have to just do everything at that moment. And I think the reason I'm like that is because I was always depending on someone growing up. It was always someone who was just like, yeah, I'll do this for you, but they never came through. So that's why I'm just like, I'll do it myself. I'll take care of this. So I think that's why I'm, like, a big doer and thinker. So that's kind of where it comes from, like not being able to rely on people and all of my mistakes or life experiences in the past. Yeah. If anyone knows how I can make these apps better, please, because I know not everyone's going to put, yeah, I cheated on my girlfriend on an app, you know, because they're never going to get it. They probably won't get a response. So, like, I'm trying to figure out how to make these things better. So if you have any responses or any feedback, please let me know.
Do you ever revisit some of your old ideas?
Yes, like old books that are like half halfway through, I'm just like, wow, that would have been cool at that moment, but now it's not really important. And that's why I like to act now, because things are relevant now compared to, you know, the future. Like, if I created a social media website right now, it probably wouldn't be as effective as when Mark did it, because he was not the first, but he made it super huge, you know. So just like with app design and stuff like this, this is the time to do it, because 5 years down the line, I don't know, it may be something different.
No.
I had a question. Sorry.
Oh.
I want to know, like, what motivates you all to make your dance? Like, what keeps you all going? Because me, I just want to make a lot of money, and I love creating things. That's just honest, being honest. It's not strictly for money, but I really love creating things. He knows it. All the people that are around me just know I could be doing this stuff for free, honestly. But, like, what makes you all, like, get out of bed and say, I'm going to make this app. Like, how does it connect to you all?
They might say classroom assignment, but I'm hoping that...
Oh, sorry.
What?
No.
My bad.
No, you're fine.
Yeah.
So. But, no, I got my idea just because I want to make money on photos. Honestly. I'm trying to just think of, like, what people want and what people need.
Mm-hmm.
And, like,
I've been through that before too. Like, I'll tell somebody something, and they're just like, "Oh yeah, that's great," and then I'll see it on Facebook,
no,
and I'm
that's
like,
"That's a really good idea."
Yeah, I totally get it, man. But
I actually, I don't know if you look at like the survey thing that we did.
Mm.
Yeah, I did two different submissions, and
oh.
My app idea was one of them.
Oh.
Well, thank you all for letting me. Thank you for letting me come. I'm glad I could come and give my story.
I'm glad that you did too, and I think that it's great for, you know, we can sit here as have an assignment for making an app and sort of in the classroom, and you're sort of in this void, right? And so having the ability to hear someone who's gone through the process and who's actually made things, and those things have in some way or another impacted people's lives because they have access to that app. You know, it gives you a different perspective. You know, it sort of justifies the purpose of the process, right? It's like, this, why are we doing these sorts of things? And you're right when you say that apps are really, they're really in right now. And you can experiment with them because there's accessible tools online and ways for you to come up with your ideas. I was going to ask about how do you feel about failing? When you come up with an idea or you make a mistake, it's almost like you just move on to the next one. It's not about hanging on to that failed attempt. It's about learning from it and moving forward. And that's the beauty of iteration and having that space.
Yeah. What I can say is when you do fail, you need a lot of friends around. You just need, it is to be self-motivated, because like when you create something and people don't really gravitate towards it, it's just like, wow, I spent my whole life on this and then someone didn't really go. Buy it. It really can frustrate you.
Mm-hmm.
Like when I wrote my first book, a girl told me if it's not about sex, it won't sell. And I was like, whoa, you know, wow, that hurts. But the same book helped me pay for school, you know,
yeah.
So I didn't really give up at that moment. It was just like, wow. And then I got so many people that told me they just don't read. So I just had to kind of keep on going no matter hearing all that stuff. So just keep on going. Have good friends and other motivated people, and you'll go far. That's it. And don't become old very young like me. Please don't do that.
De-stress. Deal with the stress. That's important. That
yeah.
Really is, especially being college students and having
yeah.
a million things going on.
So before I came here, I did everything on my own. It was just like, so now I'm not even 25, but I feel like 90. It took a real big toll on me, so. Find good friends, other motivated people, and you'll make whatever you want to make. You know, you just be. You'll see your goals happen. That's it. So thank you.
Thank you, Norman. Thank you.